Show choirs are a way of life.
Never heard of show choir? Nope, nor had we until the gong-grabbing global hit Glee blasted its way onto our TV screens. This is the end. Show choir is the proper name for Glee Club, and in American high schools, it is massive.
When I'm singing on stage, that's when I feel like, this is my moment.
Show choir is my life. What it means to me, it's just everything.
I just wish that I could have been a part of that when I was 15.
We high-kicked across America to meet the best show choirs in the States.
Come on and rock me on my tails.
And got exclusive backstage access to the country's biggest show choir sing-off.
You go to the competitions, it was cutthroat.
Most people are pretty much out for blood.
We sweat, we're out of breath, you know, like some girls like throw up after a performance.
Nice. So limber up, give great facial and brace yourself to lift the lid on the real show choirs of America.
Sing with gusto!
We all know what school is like in the UK.
Look at that.
Beautiful. Come on, guys.
Yay, that's right, they're the happiest days of your life.
They're terrible places. I mean, I went to school in Southeast London and I was assaulted every day at school. You know, if it happened now, I'd press charges immediately, every time. But because it's school, it's just a given that it's going to be like the Wild West. It's a terrible place.
If you get like a crap haircut and you have a slightly naff bag, or like if your trousers were too high, that was always one. Like if your trousers got a bit small and it was showing your ankle, we called them jack-ups, then you'd get roasted at school.
But in America, high school is a little bit different, a little bit more cheery, say. Yay, go Zach, yeah! Ah, you guys, but it's not just Zac Efron and the jocks and the nerds or the fact that they study math. There are severe musical differences between the UK and the US, you see, and it's all about choirs. Yes, choirs. If you were unlucky enough to be in a British school choir, it was probably something like this. Great. Or, if you were really unlucky, like this.
Choirs in British schools have this sort of grey vibe, I think. When I think of a choir, I think of moths in a dark cupboard eating away at a cloak that you're going to wear that's attached to some sort of ceremony that's 100 years old.
Choir at my school was Thursday evenings once a week, and it was pretty standard. We'd warm up, then we'd sing a hymn, and then we'd sing another hymn. And then after that, I think we'd sing a hymn. Did we dance? No. No. Why would we dance for a choir?
There was never any motion other than your trachea in choir. You know, you're not supposed to move. It's a choir.
But in America, it's a very different story. Over there, this is a school choir. Yes, a school choir.
I am so impressed by the show choirs in America. I just wish that I could have been a part of that when I was 15. I'm jealous, to be honest. That's all I can say.
It looks like a Broadway show. It doesn't look like a school assembly show.
But why do we suddenly care about choirs anyway? Well, because of this lot. Just a small town girl.
It's dancing, it's music, it's wit, it's crazy drama.
Oh my gosh, what a concept. It's a mini musical in an hour, and you get all your favorite pop songs sung by people that can really sing that should win American Idol, and bam, I love Glee!
The a cappella antics and jazz hands hijinks of the McKinley High School Glee Club have had us glued to the telly for ages.
It's ended up not only becoming a TV phenomenon, but a kind of general pop culture phenomenon. It's taking over the charts. People are starting up their own glee clubs all over the place.
There's glee parties. Pretty soon, they're gonna have like sing-along glee. They should do sing-along glee. They should do sing-along glee.
The success of Glee has made musicals hip, and in Hollywood, Broadway is the new black.
Lea Michele, Matthew Morrison, they're massive names in the Broadway community. Back in the day, these people had such a hard time getting hired on TV shows because musical theater people supposedly as a generality overact. Now with this show, Broadway stars have an open door. Did you study the form of musical theater? Do you know how to talk and then burst into song? And if so, you're Judy Dench.
Yes, Glee Mania has engulfed us all like a great big spangly tsunami. And most exciting of all, Glee has brought us this.
Come on and rock me on my tails.
The world of show choir. It's where starry-eyed American teens go to sing, dance, and just belt one out on stage.
Show choir is something that started in our lives as kids very early on. I think as soon as we're in first grade, we have a music class that we go to, and around Christmas, we always put on a show. And then when you get into high school, that's when it's really the show choir that we've all come to know and love, like Glee, where it's a lot of dancing, and it's a huge show, and it's musical theater at its best.
Our show choir was just called Show. It was really silly. It was called Show with Glee, but you have to do like jazz hands. Show. We would do things like Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and the choreography would go like this. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue.
We had vocal jazz ensemble where the girls, even though we're Catholic school, wore like strapless black dresses, and you do like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And that was really cool if you're one of those.
Although it may look embarrassing, studying show choir in school has actually been a stepping stone to stardom for loads of celebs. Ashton Kutcher, Gossip Girl's Blake Lively, NSYNC's Lance Bass, and Pussycat Dog Kimberly Wyatt are all former show choir shufflers.
Show choir taught me so much about singing, working with others, being on stage as a singer, and I know that it's definitely played a part in my life as I have moved on. Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? I would love to see a rendition of a Pussycat Doll song in Glee. I want to see how they do it, and I'd bet they'd do it justice.
Don't you? Now, until Glee, us Brits had never even heard of show choir, which is ironic as we actually started the whole thing with the invention of the world's first Glee Club in London in 1787. It was all male and they sang short songs called Glees. The trend reached America in 1858 when Harvard University started its Glee Club. It still exists today. Over the decades, Glee Clubs morphed into the show choirs of today. With over 900 across the United States, they are now a vital part of American high school life. Try this sort of thing in a British comprehensive and you'd probably get your head flushed down the bogs at break time. And you probably deserve it. But in America, show choir is a proper academic subject, just like geography and biology. Just think, these kids get to graduate in jazz hands, show tunes, and razzle dazzle.
This should not be part of the curriculum. I have a master's in going like this, and a PhD in going like this. You, what good is that gonna do anyone, in all honesty?
They like the way we dance, they like the way we work, they like the way the lamb is going across my shirt.
Just like the TV version of Glee, real-life show choir kids do get teased by the rest of the pupils.
The guys get beaten up on, and like really badly sometimes, like, oh, you're gay, or this and that. But actually, since Glee, it's kind of helped us. They're like, oh, show choir. But it's not the most accepted thing.
Well, many people call me like a show queer instead of show choir. Dum-dum-da-dum.
I think the show choirs are getting cooler as we go, especially with Glee on TV. It just makes it cool.
Do you think I'm sexy?
I have to say, I dated a few show choir guys in my day. I thought it was quite sexy.
Come on, baby, let me know.
But show choir's not just about singing, dancing, and fighting off the school bully. Oh no, it is about winning.
There is that winner's attitude when it comes to putting on a show and going to a competition as a show choir to be the very best that they can.
Standards at the competitions are super high. Choirs put on elaborate productions, kind of like mini Broadway musicals, complete with crazy costumes and difficult-to-do dance steps. And although they're just teenagers, they're often every bit as good as grown-up professional performers.